might know a little boy or a little girl like Wiggle Willie. And that's what I'm going to be sharing with you today. By the way, I've missed you. I hope you had a happy holiday. And I'm going to be sharing some things that you can do to help get rid of the wiggles and the fidgets when school starts. Now, I can sympathize with children who just can't seem to sit still because when I was a little girl, they called me a wiggle worm. And I think, you know, children naturally want to move, and we are expecting them to sit still so long and do so many things in front of the screen when they really just need to get up and move. And so, you know, the wiggles just kind of build up inside of them. So I have some techniques and strategies today that I hope will help you with your students to get rid of the wiggles. I always tell people my workshops, my Facebook Live is like going to the big box store. I'm going to do lots of different things. You pick and you choose what works best for you. You work with different age levels. And, you know, you never know what's going to work with children, do you? And so you just have to try. And that's one of the great challenges of being a teacher is you try new things and you hope something will work. So I've got lots of things for you to try. Now, wiggles and fidgets have always been around, but they seem to be escalating because of so much screen time. There is a really good TED video that I would encourage you to watch. It's called Why Children Fidget and What We Can Do About It. And they need recess. They need playing out time, put more time outside playing. And a lot of things you don't have control over, like, you know, what children eat at home and how much sleep they get. And so, you know, it is what it is. And we have to try to work with the children and help them as much as we can. And I also want you to be aware that you might have an administrator saying, why are you doing this? And you need to know why. It's from the brain research. Any specialist that works with children with integration needs and special needs will tell you that they just need to move. And sometimes they just need something in their hands to release those wiggles. So I've got some fidget toys. I've got lots of different fidget toys in my bag to share with you. And I hope some of these will work for you. Now, my favorite one that I used, it was just a sock. I got some old socks and knotted them up. And I called them brain toys. I just thought that was a little more positive than a fidget toy. But I had these in a box, and if children had a difficult time keeping their hands to themselves, I would invite them to get a brain toy. And they could hold this, and they could knot it and unknot it and just fiddle with it all they wanted to. Now, sometimes people say, yeah, but what if everybody in the room wants one? Do you know what? If they need it, they will get it. And if they don't need it, they won't get it. I think with my brain toys, they're not so cute that children will want to get them and play with them, but they will actually just be able to hold them in their hand and manipulate them a little bit. Now, another one, this is a fiddlestick. And this idea came from a first grade teacher. So this would work better with younger children, but this would be good with primary grade kids. They all get a jumbo craft stick and tie a piece of string to it. And you just tell them when your hands get a little bit fidgety, you can get out your little fiddlestick and you can fiddle with it and you can play with it. Play-Doh or silly putty, sometimes just a little ball of Play-Doh to hold in their hands. One teacher said, yeah, but they'll play with the Play-Doh and they won't listen to you. Well, there was a teacher who wrote a book, and I think it was in Smart Moves and by Hanahan, and she said that she taught a college course and she gave them each Play-Doh and they got to mess with the Play-Doh while she lectured, and they said that was the best college course they ever took. So, you know, sometimes you just need a little bit more input in the brain. Now, this is a little squishy ball. This is just a balloon, and I filled it with flour, or you can use cornstarch and knot it at the top, and they can just hold it. You can purchase these, but I'm just showing you common things that you would find around your house. Sometimes just a pom-pom, just a little pom-pom to hold, or maybe a pipe cleaner. And I mentioned this on my Facebook page yesterday, and somebody said the jumbo pipe cleaners would work even better, which I thought was a really good idea. A little straw, little bendy straws that they could just hold and quietly bend. I also like this little stress button. This is a poker chip And I glued Velcro with the hooky side to the back of it. I used E6000 glue because I found that's just the very best for making things stick. And you can invite the children to hold this. Another teacher said that this was for primary grade children, she glued the Velcro underneath their desk. And so if their hands got a little fidgety, they could just look up, wiggle them around under their desk. There are lots of other little things children can hold, like nuts and bolts, and they can just screw it and unscrew it. One little post that I looked at mentioned these little hair bands or even a rubber band just to put it around their wrist and play with it. A pipe cleaner with some little beads that they can twist around. Or, you know, simple things like a little spring clothespin that they can hold and wiggle. Or maybe a little butterfly clip that they can open and close and open and close. Now, some of these things you might want to put in a special corner in your room. I like to call it Hawaii, and you put up a poster of Hawaii and put a beach towel on the floor and then put some of these little toys over there and just tell them if you feel a little bit fidgety, you can go over there and you can play with some of these toys. It gives them some self-regulation that they can take care of. How about this? You know, look how good this is for releasing wiggles. The smaller the bubble wrap, the smaller the sound it'll make when it pops, which is good. You won't believe this, but a couple of the sites mentioned gum, giving children gum to chew. That helped get rid of the wiggles. I know some of you are in schools where you couldn't do that, but I thought it was interesting. It was also interesting that some brain research people think that gum actually helps children learn, because when you constrict those blood vessels and chew, it sends blood to the brain. Sometimes you might want, for the older kids, you might want to give them a little pad of paper and a pen, something they have in their hands and they can take notes and listen at the same time. It gets rid of the wiggles. And then I also have some calm down lotion. You can get some disinfectant and call it your calm down lotion or your magic lotion, and you can pass it around and children can rub it in their hands and kind of give their hands a little massage there. So lots of different things, lots of different choices that you can have to help children get rid of the fidgets. One other thing I wanted to mention, somebody said coloring books were really good for the fidgets. Now, you know me, I'm the last person that would say do coloring books with children because I like them to be a lot more creative. But when you think about it, if you had a little special area in your room with coloring books that they could go over, and just when they color, they really do focus and keep those little hands busy. Okay, so next part of Fidget Fixers I'd like to talk about is how to start your day. It's always good to have the kids stand up, sing a song, start your day. I have lots of free ones on YouTube. Time to Get Up, Rise and Shine, Feeling Fine, lots of different ones. But I also wanted to share this idea. If you didn't want to use music, the students stand in a circle and you start this chant. This is Queen, We Will Rock You. So you stomp twice and then clap. We think Joey is super. We think Mary is super. And you go around the room and use each child's name in the chant. Now, take a different vocabulary word each day. So, we think Mary is awesome, or we think Mary is spectacular, or we think Mary is extraordinary. Choose one vocabulary word, one adjective each day. Go around the circle, use each child's name in it. And that just something about stomping and clamping gets blood going to the brain and gets rid of the wiggles. Now, you need lots of wiggle breaks during the day. I started off with that song, Wiggle Willie. You know, I have many different songs that you can do that release the wiggles, like Tootie Ta and the Button Factory and different ones. But some other things that you can do for wiggle breaks, you can just have the children stand up and jump. Just jump, you know, see how many times you can jump. You can have them march. You can put on some music and have them march. Can you march and lift your knees high? Can you march and turn in a circle? Can you march on your tippy toes? I have a YouTube video with some marching ideas on it as well. Another thing that you can do, this one came from Carolyn Koslowski, it's called run and walk. So you have the children run as fast as they can for 20 seconds in place, and then they walk for 10 seconds in place. Then they run in place, and then they walk in place. Now, if you had a Fitbit, that might be kind of fun to tie that math in with your Fitbit as children do some of these things. And then yesterday I mentioned on Facebook a wiggle break in the hall. While you're waiting in the hall, to have them put their hands up against the wall and push the wall as hard as you can. You can do push-ups as you push the wall, and you can count, or you can spell the word half. H-A-V-E. I mean, there's lots of different things that you can do, and you're developing that upper body and getting rid of wiggles. Now, I also wanted to talk about some wiggle breaks that you can do when children sit in their chair, because sometimes they get all excited and wound up. But if they sit in the chair, it gives them a place. And so I'll just do this one little song with you. It's called The Chair Can-Can. And so they sit in the chair.
Oh, fun! We get to do the chair can-can. Sit in your seat and bounce your feet up and down to the beat.
In the video, you kick your right foot, kick your left foot, you kick across, heel up. There's all sorts of different things that you can do with your feet, sitting in a chair and dancing. I also like to do hand dancing. And this one is something you can use with any type of music. If you like your college fight song, you use that song. If you like country, use country music. Whatever music appeals to you, use that. Because the teacher adds the magic. If you're feeling the music and you're feeling the love, you're going to pass that on to your children. So I've also got lots of learning songs where children can get up and move, and they can exercise and count and say letters and make all sorts of different sounds. I also wanted to show you some little finger fidget exercises, and they are actually recommending that some people who sit in front of a computer all day do these things. Grown-ups do these things to take a break. So you have the children put their hands together like this, and then push one side, and then push the other side, and try to keep them from pushing from one side to the other side. And then you can let them push their thumbs one way and then the other way, and then push pointers, and then tall man, and ring man, and pinky. And then you can do the same type thing where they do the little spider clap, and then you can tap pinkies, and ring man, and tall man, and pointer, and thumbkin. And then you can clasp your fingers, and you can twiddle your thumbs one way, and then reverse the other direction. And then what's fun is to clasp your hands and put the other thumb on top, and twiddle, and twiddle. And you can also call this the beehive, and the baby bees, and then the ring bees wiggle, and the tall bees, and the pointer bees, and the thumb bees. And when you're doing these finger exercises, you just focus and release all of that tension and all of that stress. Of course, you know how I love finger plays. They are always wonderful for getting rid of the wiggles and using their little hands. I also wanted to recommend some relaxation techniques that you can use with the children. One of them is called tighten and relax. So can you make your fingers as tight as you can? Tighter, tighter, tighter. And then let them relax. And then make your shoulders tight, tight as you can. And then let them relax. And then you can do your eyes, and you can do your mouth, and you can do your elbows, and you can do your knees, and you can do all of your different body parts, work from the top to the bottom, and then make your whole body as tight as you can, and then let it relax. And it's just, it is such a calming thing to do. And do you see, I'm not doing anything hard. I'm not doing anything expensive. I'm just doing little things that you can throw in if you've got 2 or 3 minutes just to make you feel better and your children feel better. I also wanted to mention balancing. Balancing is such a powerful way to help children self-regulate. You see, when we're doing these things, we hear so much now about SEL, social emotional learning. That's what we're doing with these fidget fixers. We are helping children focus on themselves and self-regulate. And so when they balance, you can balance on one foot, you can balance on the other foot. You can balance on tiptoes on one foot, tiptoes on the other foot. You can balance and put one leg out in the air and then put it down. There's lots of different ways that you can balance. And again, some nice peaceful music really helps when you do these things. Yoga is also wonderful for reducing fidgets. And there are some really good videos out there and different people doing yoga for children. Did want to mention a little fidget sticks that what you might want to do is you try out some of these different activities. You said that if the kids like it, you go, hey, that was fun. I liked it. Did you? Well, let's say that. And so you write the title on a jumbo craft stick and you put it on a little can, a fidget can. And then when you need a fidget fixer, you can just let the children choose one out and you'll always have one ready to do. I also wanted to mention about having the children talk about what is a fidget? What is a wiggle? Why do you do it? How does it make you feel? What can you do about it? And you could even make a book called What Do You Do When You Have Fidgets? And let them all draw a picture, write a sentence about what to do, or the younger children could dictate a sentence about what they could do. This would be a good one to put in your little fidget corner, wouldn't it, where they could go and relax and rest a little bit. So I hope you've gotten some new ideas today. All of these are listed in a book that Carolyn Koslowski and I recently made called Fidget Fixers. There's over 80 activities of different materials and codes and for links for the different songs and different things that I've been doing. You can also go to drjeanandfriends.blogspot.com and get lots of ideas there. Just put it in the search engine. I am excited because I'm going to be going to California this week for the California Kindergarten Teachers Conference in Santa Clara. A week from Monday, I will be in Columbus, Ohio at the Kindergarten Teachers Conference. I'm also going to be in Arkansas the end of January, and then Pennsylvania, and then New Jersey, and Virginia, and I've got lots of exciting conferences coming up, so I hope I'll see you there, and take care, God bless, and hope you have a fidgety new year.